So the University of Minnesota appears to still not have entirely learned their lesson. It's been about 1 week since the entire university was banned from submitting commits to the Linux kernel after some of their security researchers were caught doing hypocrite commits, which of course is when we pretend to fix a bug, or sometimes we might legitimately fix a small bug like a typo or something like that, but then introduce a much more severe vulnerability at the same time within the same commit. And some of these folks at the university, they still don't seem to understand exactly what they did wrong. So let's take a look at this open letter that was written to the Linux community from one of the assistant professors that I believe was overseeing the security research that actually led to this whole debacle. And since this is an open letter to the Linux community, it's actually a letter to you and me as well. So let's see what they have to say to us. It starts off with an apology. So we sincerely apologize for any harm our research group did to the Linux kernel community. Our goal was to identify issues with the patching process and ways to address them, and we are very sorry that the method used in the hypocrite commits paper was inappropriate. As many observers have pointed out to us, we made a mistake by not finding a way to consult with the community and obtain permission before running this study. We did that because we know we could not ask the maintainers of Linux for permission, or they would be on the lookout for the hypocrite patches. While our goal was to improve the security of Linux, we now understand that it was hurtful to the community to make it a subject of our research and to waste its effort reviewing these patches without its knowledge or permission. We want you to know that we would never intentionally hurt the Linux kernel community and never introduce security vulnerabilities. Our work was conducted with the best of intentions and is all about finding and fixing security vulnerabilities. The hypocrite commits work was carried out in August 2020. It aimed to improve the security of the patching process in Linux. As part of the project, we studied potential issues with the patching process of Linux, including cases of the causes of the issue and suggestions for addressing them. This work did not introduce vulnerabilities into the Linux code. The three incorrect patches were discovered and stopped during exchanges in a Linux message board and never committed to the code. We reported the findings and our conclusion, excluding the incorrect patches of the work to the Linux community before paper submission, collected their feedback, and included them in the paper. And I have a link to that paper in my other video that I did about this, by the way. All the other 190 patches being reverted and reevaluated were submitted as part of other projects and as a service to the community, and they are not related to the hypocrite commits paper. These 190 patches were in response to real bugs in the code and all correct as far as we can discern when we submitted them. We understand the desire of the community to gain access to and examine the three incorrect patches. Doing so would reveal the identities of members of the community who responded to these patches on the message board. Therefore, we are working to obtain their consent before revealing these patches. Our recent patches in April 2021 are not part of the hypocrite commits paper either. We have been conducting a new project that aims to automatically identify bugs introduced by other patches, not from us. Our patches were prepared and submitted to fix the identified bugs to follow the rules of responsible disclosure, and we are happy to share details of this new project with the Linux community. We are a research group whose members devote their careers to improving the Linux kernel. We have been working on finding and patching vulnerabilities in Linux for the past 5 years. The past observations with the patching process has motivated us to also study and address issues with the patching process itself. This current incident has caused a great deal of anger in the Linux community towards us, the research group, and the University of Minnesota. We apologize unconditionally for what we now recognize was a breach of the shared trust in the open source community and seek forgiveness for our missteps. We seek to rebuild the relationship with the Linux Foundation and the Linux community from a place of humility to create a foundation from which we hope we can once again contribute to our shared goal of improving the quality and security of Linux software. We will work with our department as they develop new training and support for faculty and students seeking to conduct research on open source projects, peer production sites, and other online communities. All right, so pretty wordy there. Now, this might just be me interpreting this letter wrong, but it really doesn't seem that sincere to me. Like, you can just tell when somebody is genuinely sorry that they did something wrong versus just sorry that they got caught. Usually, the apology ends up being really long and drawn out, like this, when it's that kind of an apology. And they even make an excuse within this apology letter to try and justify their behavior, basically saying that they couldn't ask the kernel maintainers for permission because then they would be on the lookout for those hypocrite commits, and basically it would screw up the entire study, so that's why they just went ahead and did it. The thing is, though, there's actually several maintainers for the Linux kernel. You don't have to ask all of them. You really only need to get permission from one, ideally a more senior maintainer of the kernel that will allow you to basically do a test on the other ones instead of you just trying to test them all at the same time. And if you're really concerned with testing all of the maintainers, why not just do different tests at different times? You could get permission from maintainer A for test one, and then permission from maintainer B for test two. That way everybody is ultimately getting tested to see if they can identify your hypocrite commits. So let's take a look at Greg KH's response. So he's one of the major kernel developers, and we got a nice short and sweet response here. So thank you for your response. As you know, the Linux Foundation and the Linux Foundation's Technical Advisory Board submitted a letter on Friday to your university outlining the specific actions which need to happen in order for your group and your university to be able to work to regain the trust of the Linux kernel community. Until those actions are taken, we do not have anything further to discuss about the issue. Thanks. And by the way, they sent a letter to them on Friday about what they basically need to do to clean up their act. And I believe that this was written on Sunday. Yeah. Or actually, the original apology letter was written on Saturday. So there you go. They've already had what they need to do for about a day, and then they decided to do this apology letter instead. Hopefully they had somebody working on that, because obviously they need to do whatever was in that letter. We don't have access to that, or at least I couldn't find a copy of that. I don't think it's really open to the public. But yeah, that's apparently the only way that they're actually going to get their privileges back. Now, you know, at first I thought that banning the entire University of Minnesota from submitting commits was a little bit too far, but until there really is a serious response from the university about this and corrections are put into place to make sure that it doesn't happen again, I think that the full ban is fair. Plus, apparently there's been a lot of other shenanigans that are coming from the University of Minnesota for a while that are unrelated to this. So it really seems to me like there is just a deep-rooted problem within that university. Like, I don't know why there would be so many flare-ups and drama going on in different areas if there wasn't. And of course, the people who I really feel sorry for, like, I don't feel sorry for the university. You know, they've got plenty of money and plenty of tenure. I really feel sorry for the students. They're really the ones that are getting screwed here. But if you're a student there, you really just have to realize that your school's reputation is damaged, and this could potentially devalue your degree if you're competing in the job market for someone else who went to a different university. So maybe the degree from University of Minnesota might not be worth as much effort as you're putting into it. You know, maybe you can transfer schools. I know that that kind of sucks to do and usually costs a lot of money. But unless the university gets its act together, if you want to do anything with the Linux kernel, it's going to have to be outside of school hours, because there's a full ban on all of your school's domains. And obviously trying to circumvent that to still do schoolwork using different email addresses isn't going to be a good idea. That's just going to piss off the kernel maintainers even more. But again, if you're a student here, you might really want to consider getting credentials outside of your university, because cybersecurity firms, they might think twice about hiring a graduate from UMN if they didn't even learn the basic rule of security audits, which is get permission from the owner before you try to penetrate them. Otherwise, it's just an attack.